concept you want. And when hell hit, the scripture says, man, where's manana is going to be the stability of thy time. Right. When that hell hits, you got all these scriptures in you, and you ain't went and did the work, and ain't did shit. Guess what? You're going to be out here fucked up.
That's right. Apostle Ricard said it best. You ain't been battle tested.
That's right. Come on, brother. Bill,
you
he
been,
sure
you
did.
You been battle tested, man.
That's right. Hey, man, they even tell you that in the corporate world, man.
Precept.
They get a guy fresh out of college, and then a guy that's been on a job that got fired from a job, they'll be like, hey, okay, we got a new guy fresh out of college. They'll be like, what other choice we got? We got another guy that's been fired from a job. He's been laid off for a couple. Does he know the job? Yes, he's been experienced. I want him. They don't want no greenhorns, man. They don't want no new guys, man. The brother's been in the military, man. If you come to battle, man, you want somebody that's been battle tested, man. I want somebody that's been in combat, been got shot at.
Yeah, qualified.
You know what I'm saying? That qualifies you, man. Don't throw no motherfucking greenhorn in the pit with me, man. Because he don't know what the fuck to do. Go ahead, Al.
This is Luke chapter 9, verse 23. And he said, and to them all, if any man will come after me, let him deny himself.
That's right. Deny yourself, man. Quit thinking that you can get anything accomplished in this world, man. You can't get shit done, man. When you go out and fill an application, man, you pray your heart about Hashem Yahushua. If it see fit that you get that job, man. Mm-hmm. He Lord might not willing. Even want you there, man. You say, Lord willing, man. Bar Ratazah, man. You don't fucking be trying to do shit on your fucking own, man. That's what's wrong with Jay. That's always right. Think you can fucking accomplish something, man. You ain't shitting this motherfucker, man.
Yep. Hey, once you get a degree, you just a nigga with a degree.
Yeah, you basically a trained ass monkey. Now they ready for your ass to go out there and turn tricks.
Yeah, and then you're not gonna get a job in the field that you have a degree in. You don't get a job at motherfucking Walmart manager.
Nah.
You gotta, yeah. Here it is, you got a business degree. Or you got a degree in biology, and you a goddamn manager at Walmart. Man.
Yeah. My pops were for assistant. My pops went to took a three-month course in pharmaceutical after he retired. They didn't want him in that field, man. They want that field for fucking women. They got sick. That's why I said, but this school shit got you niggas fucked up. Y'all bugged out of your fucking minds, man. Watch what the fuck you go to school for, man, because this devil, man, it's got you, he got your ass pegged. That's the last little hustle of America, man.
Yeah.
Once this school, these school loans and this economy hit rock bottom, that's the last little hustle in America, man. It's these school loans and shit, man. Because everybody's going to school, man. It's not gonna come out and prosper like they make you think, man. They're putting y'all, this whole society is built off debt, transferring the debt, man. You don't own shit, man. When you go buy that new, get that new car, man, it's debt.
Yeah,
they going off your credit. You don't pay for shit, man.
You don't own shit, man.
You don't own shit.
Hey, you pay for that car. What do you have to do? You have to have insurance. You got to get plates. You know what I'm saying? You got to get your license. You got to get that renewed every so often.
Every so often, right.
You know, all that costs money, man.
That's right. That's right, man.
So you become a slave to that vehicle, man. All these people driving around, they slaves to these vehicles, man. Talking about I own a car, man. You don't own shit, man. And what happened? They told you how much you don't own shit. Police pull you over and you ain't paid them fees, they will take your fucking car, that's right? If you ain't renewed your license, they will take your car.
They'll take your car.
If you don't have insurance, they'll take your fucking car.
That's right.
That's right.
So you don't own shit, man.
That's right.
You can go
go to some whole ass college, man. Buy them a house out in the fucking suburbs and think they own some shit, man.
Hey,
if you don't have a Lord, you ain't own shit.
Come on, that's right, brother. Come on.
Hey,
come on.
I'm gonna say this.
Hey, get that.
I got a precept on that.
Get that.
Come up here.
All right.
Hey, I wish I was just like y'all, man.
Hey, man, it ain't got nothing to do with us.
Y'all stay encouraged, man. Keep doing what you're doing.
Hey, no, listen, brother. We're going to stay encouraged. Listen, we're going to stay encouraged. But, hey, man, the scripture says, man, this day we're going to serve. You can walk away from here right now, man. The Lord can let your ass get hit by one of these cars. Right now, you're hearing the men of the Lord, bro. You got to choose right now, man.
What's
God. Because, bro, I mean, it ain't us about being right, encouraged, bro.
We just want you to block the sign.
Yeah, man. I got it, bro.
Come on, this side.
What do you read? What do you brother read?
Con, this is Proverbs 1 verse 21. She crieth in the chief place of concourse.
Jump up, go to 1 and 2.
Con, wisdom crieth without. She utter her voice in the streets.
Which is what we're doing right now, man. Wisdom, man. Now, wisdom is something you're supposed to have, man. Especially wisdom of the scriptures, man. Right? It's knowledge, man. All right? Like smoking cigarettes, that's not wisdom, man. Right? That's not knowledge, man. Now, on the back of the market of the cigarettes, it says what? It may cause cancer, man. That's not wise, man. Read.
Cut. She crieth in the chief place of concourse.
Hey, it's the reason why people smoke cigarettes, because they don't have the Lord, man. So that void that's in their life that's missing,
yeah.
they look for comfort through what's called a substance abuse.
Yeah.
Or self-medication.
Yeah.
This right. makes me feel better. Well, make you feel better for what?
Yeah.
Because you don't have a Lord, and in your conscience, you know that you're not right. That's why you need something to make you feel better.
Right.
You know, it's because we all smoke. I smoke. I can't say all of us, but I used to smoke in the world.
Oh, yeah, I used to smoke.
I was in the military. I used to smoke packs of cigarettes in a day, man.
That's called instant gratification, man.
Yeah, man. Because you know what? They don't want to deal with the consequences at hand. So they need that little extra help.
Yeah.
We don't none of us smoke no more. You know why? Because we got that Lord. We got the Lord. The Lord put that flesh on us,
yeah.
To fill that void, man. So we don't have to feel confident through our things, man. We know what our purpose in life is and what direction this world is going in. We know those things, man. So we don't have to wonder about, man, how am I gonna do such and such? Or how am I gonna pay this bill? Because when you got the Lord, the Lord will carry you, man.
That's right.
You cast your cares on him,
yeah.
man.
Yeah. Just saying that again, man. You saying you should be like a. Just hear what the brother just said.
Now you're an Israelite,
you know? Smoke, man. The only thing you need to know, brother, is that you're an Israelite. The Lord is dealing with ops right, man. All right? If you really want to quit them cigarettes, man, you will set up here, man, and hold them cigarettes down, man. You will listen, man. Because that's the only way you're going to get that. The Lord is dealing with you, man. That's the only way you're going to be delivered. And you have to hope deliver.
Hey, you're an Israelite. You have an opportunity to be like us, but how
right.
committed are you?
That's
when
right.
you say that. Is you, are you saying that to make us feel good?
Yeah.
Or are you saying that because you really want to be like we are?
Ain't hey, worry about no some people. We're talking about he asked you. Not some people, you, man. You throwing the blame, and then when you walk up and you stand with you like that, because that's really, I'm really picking up on you. That's a demon, man.
Man, that's doubt,
bro.
That's the spirit of doubt right
not
there. Wish,
that.
You saying I wish I could be like somebody. That's the spirit of doubt. Because you don't believe. Right?
We know better than you.
Yeah, we telling you that you could. He just said he smoked. I smoke weed. I used to be a witch in the world dealing with drugs, man. Okay? But when I heard this truth, I took it and ran with it, man.
Yeah.
That's how I was able to conform to be the way the house shop wants me to be. That's the Lord's name.
But I ain't came up out of it.
Bro, listen, you're not gonna come up out of it, bro. When
unless
I came
you,
into this truth, I was actually
coming
smoking,
around
man.
The man of the Lord.
That's right.
Hey, if you keep coming around the man of the Lord, eventually them demons gotta leave.
That's right.
That's why that dude couldn't stay, the dude with the dreads, that's why he couldn't stay long.
That's right.
Because the spirit had him in a position where he got uncomfortable.
That's right.
Hey, you keep coming around the man of the Lord, you see us out here, you come out here, them demons will leave, man.
That's right.
The Lord will cleanse you, man, but you gotta stay committed. See, and some people live their whole life without committing to nothing, man. You gotta, if you really wanted to do it, you could, man. The Lord will give you strength to do it. If you believed in him and said, Lord, I want to stop doing this. I want to stop smoking cigarettes. I want to be right. If you really sincerely came to the Lord with that, he will test you, man, and see where your head at. And see, hey, if you really want to serve me, then do this, do
that's
that.
Right.
Listen to those prophets.
That's right.
Become subject unto teachers, you know? You know, so you're an Israelite. First of all, you should be happy that you're one of them people on that side. You know what I'm saying? Because those are the people of God. Second of all, you got to start coming around, man. You got to start, hey, if we come out here every Sunday at 3, between 3 and 3:30. You, hey, come out here, bring your scriptures. If you really want to be a man of the Lord and serve the Lord, you got to discipline yourself. And you got to seek after him, man. Because it's not just going to come up on you like while you're sitting on your couch. it's not just gonna hit you. I'm a man of the Lord. No, you gotta work for it, man. And the scriptures say, hey, hey.
Self-made dudes.
Yeah, man.
Sure, self-made dudes.
Hey, yeah. Hey, the Lord said, draw nine to me, and I'll draw nine to you.
Right.
So, you heard this word. This is a good start right here. If you really want to serve the Lord, this is a good start, man.
I got
to come out here and listen to the brothers teaching the word and take it to heart, man, and take the things that we say and go and try to stop sinning, man. Now, we know you're not going to stop sinning. It's hard. It's hard to stop sinning, man. When I first came to the truth, I was smoking weed and cigarettes,
right?
You know? But I was sincere in my spirit that I wanted to serve the Lord. You know what I'm saying? And I kept coming around and listening to the brothers and taking what they said and applying it to my life. And eventually the Lord gave me the power to change. You know what I'm saying? It's not just gonna fall upon you when you leave here today and you never come back. It's not just gonna fall upon you one day like, oh, I'm a man of the Lord, I got all of it. You know, you gotta work for it, man. Everything in life you gotta work for, right? So why not work for the Lord, man?
How'd you get them squares?
wait, how do you think we got this through?
We didn't hustle. We didn't hustle for it, but we worked for it. You know what I'm saying?
Hey, hustle is
nice.
We didn't hustle like in a bad way.
You say what? Study to show thyself approved.
That's right.
Yeah. Work for that needed for shit. So we study to get this knowledge.
Don't act on it.
That's right.
And that's worse.
Ain't
that.
But that's the part. That's the part now, ladies. You know. So now you have to do it. What are you doing right now? Aren't you here listening? What is that a form of? Acting on. This is the beginning right here. You just found out you're Israelite.
I just got laid out.
You ain't got, no you don't. Listen, quit saying I. Didn't his brother just tell you he was smoking when he came to the truth? I was smoking when I was getting the truth. Read the scriptures, had my boy rolled in the blunt. He was like, they kept calling me, and I kept standing in the word, and eventually, I said, man, go ahead. And guess what, from that day on, he has to take it from me. All you gotta do is keep coming to the man of the Lord, and we'll give you the name, and you study, and start reading your scriptures. You know what I'm saying? We got Bible study, we got brothers here, we got numbers. Call brothers, if you're sincere, man, don't waste our time. Don't play with the Lord.
Yeah, because the Lord, the Lord killed many people came up here and said, I want to be right, and then take the proper procedures of being right. And you end up seeing them in the paper dead. The Lord killed you because the word of the Lord, man. Hey, man, this is a fearful thing, man. Hey, you become subject and accountable to these things that we're reading once you hear them. You know what I'm saying? Once you hear them, you're not ignorant of it anymore. So you become subject to do those things.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? So so we tell you to stop smoking cigarettes. You should be like, hey, if you don't really need a cigarette, it should be something in you like, I don't really need a cigarette right now.
Yeah.
I ain't stressed out right now, so why am I smoking a cigarette? You know what I'm saying? I'm happy right now, so I don't need a cigarette. You know?
Scripture says the mind is willing, but the flesh is weak.
So you gotta work towards that goal.
That's right.
Man. If the goal not gonna be set right in front of you for you to grab it. A goal is a distance away.
That's right.
You hear what I'm saying?
That's right.
You gotta work towards it, man. You know what I'm saying? All these things that are weighing you down, you gonna have to eventually shed them.
Yeah.
And try, as you work towards that goal, and as you get more fluent in your work towards that goal, you start shedding off them goals. You find out that's just weight. It's just dead weight, man. You find out that those things are weight. They're keeping you from what you're trying to get to. You know what I'm saying? Who runs a marathon with a goddamn backpack on, man? When they run a marathon, what do they wear? They wear those thin shorts. They wear the thinnest thing possible. That's running shoes.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Who run a marathon with Timberlands on? You know what I'm saying? Because you got to shed that weight, man.
And just by looking at you, we can tell that we can tell you're going through hell. But, bro, we was going through hell. But guess what? The men of the Lord is the ones that go through hell, man. The Lord dealing. Man, we still going through hell.
Hey, Apostle Paul, he wrote, them that are weary, come and rest with us.
That's right, brother.
What do you rest in? You rest in the word, man.
That's right.
Because the word is all we got, man.
That's it. That's all we know.
But if you walk away from this to this very day and you don't take heed to who you are and keep the law, statutes, and the commandments, you know, then you marked, man. You marked for death. The Lord is gonna get rid of your ass, man. I ain't saying he's gonna kill you right off the top, but eventually, brother, it's the nuclear destruction, you know, what's gonna come upon America, or martial law. Hey, somebody get Ezekiel 18 and 30.
I know what you're saying.
You know, then the Lord is gonna jack you up, man, because we in a time of judgment, man. You know what happened in Florida last night? The Lord killed 50 faggots, man. 50 faggots, man.
That's right.
Judgment, man.
Yep.
Which it was rightfully so, man.
That's right.
You know? You got that?
Got it.
Go ahead.
Ezekiel chapter 18, verse 30. Therefore will I judge you, O house of Israel.
See, therefore will I judge you, O house of Israel. Read.
Everyone according to his ways.
See, everyone according to his ways. So if you were smoking weed, committing adultery, being a homosexual, the Lord is going to judge you according to that, man. Read.
Saith the Lord Yahweh.
Saith the Lord Yahweh. Read.
Repent.
Repent. What's the word repent means? What? To turn back. Turn back to what? The righteous ways, man. Repent, man. All right? And how you repent is knowing the Lord's name, man. Yahweh Bashiach. That's the only way you can repent, man. Is having the correct name, man. Like I was telling you earlier, man. All right? So he can hear your prayer. Read.
Say of the Lord Yahweh.
Uh-huh.
Repent and turn yourself from all your transgressions.
See, turn your way from all your transgressions, man. All your sins, man. Read.
So iniquity shall not be your ruin.
See, so iniquity, so sin won't be your ruin. Because that's what's going to happen. You're going to ruin yourself through sinning, man. You're going off, man. And all these years, we didn't know who we were. We were eating pork, smoking cigarettes, committing adultery. No, and whatever other sin that's under the sun, man. You know, we was doing all that, man. But now this is your chance to repent, come back to the Heavenly Father and His Son, man. And actually walk in through the straight gate, man. As the scriptures say, man. You want to walk straight, the straight and narrow, man. Because these people in the churches and people in these other religions, man, they're not walking through the straight gate, man. They're teaching you how to basically try to pacify the Lord, which there's no way to pacify the Lord, man. It's the Lord said do it this way, and that's the way you have to do it, man. That's plain, man. Ain't no like Demarcus played a song of it. Ain't no half stepping, man. Ain't no half stepping, man. Hey, man, you gonna try to half step and the Lord is gonna step on your ass.
Hey man, hey, because our people catching hell, man. Hey man, our people we catching hell, man. You know what? And you know what? And it's basically by the hands of more than anybody, you know, by the hands of the white man.
Yeah. And then
the so-called white man.
Then second, who's second? Your woman.
Right. Yeah.
This is the white man, your goddamn woman. Then your damn self, man, or probably your kids, man, or whatever, or bills, whatever bullshit you gotta deal with in this present world, man. You know, we're the kings of the earth, man, and we're stuck in these ghettos, man, and constantly oppressed, man.
Preset.
You know, constantly, man, constantly down and trodden, man. But this word is this word we got is to uplift you and put you in a kingly state of mind, man. You know, not like you ain't supposed to be that nigga, man. That's why, hey, somebody give me that in Galatians, man. I think it's finish that. Paul said, who have made you turn back to these beggarly elements, man? You know. Because that's all it is. The world, man, is beggarly elements, man. You know? Bondage, man. Now, we're still in physical bondage, but John, in the book of John, he said, you should know the truth, and the truth will set you free.
Make you free.
So you gotta free your mind first, man. But once you free your mind, then you will know that our Lord, Yahweh Shai, he's the one that's going to actually free us, man. First from these bodies, but also out of Babylon, which is America, man. And get us the hell out of here, man.
Yeah, man. Because at the end of this, there's a reward. You know what I'm saying? We're not doing all this suffering for nothing. There's a reason behind all everything that we go through. when you get deep into the scriptures,